Hey folks, Landstryder here. Welcome back to episode 24 in my Utopia Resurrection series. Today, you can see behind me I've got the computer craft monitor up. I have completed the program that will operate the holodeck. And I've gone ahead and done all the wiring and stuff. Nothing going on here right now, but I've gone ahead and created one holodeck program. We're gonna come on up here so that I can example this. I haven't had a chance to do any of these other ones yet. These ones are still blank. But I've created the Eden one. It's not really that great, but it's not too much I can do in a 16 cubed area. And well, anyway, you'll see it whenever we get to that part. So I got a little manual control up here while I was working with it earlier, because I don't have the computer program loaded. But I want to talk about how this is connected first. Originally, I was going to put the computer up here. There's an issue with that, because I can't use wireless modems. You can see that I've put in some networking cable. Excuse me. Some networking cable down to the computer. And you turn these off and on by just right-clicking them. You want to make sure it has that little red ring on it whenever. Relatively cheap recipes, too. If we look, I'll show you those real quick. Networking cable, really cheap, just stone, round piece of redstone, gives you six, so not bad there. And then modems right here, the wired modem, which by the way does share a recipe with one of the new chisel blocks, but the chisel blocks will allow you to substitute the colored stone. So where the wired modem will not. So if you put a piece of colored stone in, you can get around that little overlap in recipes right now. Then I had to use this thing, prehensile proxy, because I cannot attach a modem directly to the side of a chest because it's not a full block. You know, it's got a little bit of space around it, and it's a tile entity. So you have to use a prehensile proxy for things like that. There's a chicken above me in the garden. So that's how I've gotten the chest connected to the computer down here. Now, the reason I couldn't put the computer up there is because when you're trying to capture the clicks, you know, like when I right-click this, that will only work. It won't work over a network. So if I click on the monitor, it won't send that information down the network cable to the computer that I clicked on it or where I clicked on it. It'll only work if the computer's connected directly to the monitor on one of the sides. Did a bunch of testing. It's a limitation I couldn't overcome. So I just decided to put the computer over here connected to the monitor and connect the chest remotely using the network cable, which seems to work. Okay. Then the other thing I needed to do was I needed to be able to send a redstone signal from the computer to the controller down there, the spatial I/O port. So it's connected to that actual controller, and then it sends that redstone to the adjacent block, that redstone signal to the adjacent block. Little thing about the redstone cable, I don't know if it's what kind of bug it is or whatever. Those are not actually connected. There's not actually a connection there. I think it's a client server desync issue. And when if you click, like if I click the center of this, it should change it into no connection mode. What it'll actually do on the server is it'll crash me to the login screen. So I know I won't do it. I did it several times, and whenever I did that, I came back on and it became like this ghost image that I can't now get rid of. So I had to go through, and on each individual one, you can see there's kind of like an outline box there. So I can, you know, click that through and then get rid of it. So that's how I ended up getting rid of all of the connections, because I don't really need it to connect, because otherwise it'll try to connect to every block that, you know, every one of these blocks it'll attempt to connect to. And it looked really ugly when it was all of those connections. So just went through and kind of cleaned it up a little bit. So that sends a strong redstone signal into the controller, which then goes ahead and transmits a weak signal over to the I/O port, It's really hard for me to click. I only got that tiny little sliver of space to reach it, which is fine, because after I've set this up, I shouldn't need to get into it anymore. Okay, I think that explains all the way the connections and the reason it looks like this. So the next thing would be to load the program that I wrote. Of course, I wrote this in a single player world because it's a lot easier to edit computer code. Let me say, first of all, let's delete the holo program. No? How about delete holo? I'm a bit rusty with my computer craft. There we go. I should have got rid of it. If we list now, there we go. We got startup, which if we edit startup, we should see that startup is set to run the program holo, shell.run, and then the thing in parentheses is the program it's going to run. And then you can pass parameters to that by, you know, like adding comma and then putting the parameter in parentheses as well, you know, like if you wanted to send some variables to that program. We don't need to do anything like that. We just need to, whenever it's rebooted, attempt to run the program holo. And exit. So now I need to get the program from the paste bin that I set up earlier. So if I go paste bin get, and I want to call that holo. Okay. I'm going to leave that up for just a few seconds so you guys can keep note of what that is. Anyway, there we go. Connecting, downloaded as holo. So now all I need to do is hold control and hit and hold R for a few seconds. The computer will reboot. And it should automatically be running the Holodeck program already. Now hopefully, hey, look at that. I got buttons. I'm going to go through this program a little bit, so I apologize for all you people that aren't really interested in computer craft and the code and stuff that goes into this, but I'm running out of things to do, so if you got things for me to do that you want to see me do before the series ends, you know, be sure and leave a comment on this video so that I can maybe you can give me some ideas of things that I haven't done or haven't covered. Or things I need to go back and cover again, just because you want to do it. You just kind of want to see me do it or see it better explained. So, theoretically, if I click that, there it goes. It's loading. Whoa, something went bad. And, okay. Clearly, I have messed something up. Let's see what it says in here. I didn't expect it to work the very first time. I figured I'd have to do something. It errored out somehow. Didn't give me a very clear error, though. Let me come up here. Oh, I bet I know what's up. Let me check something right here. Let's see. That is chest 0, container chest 0. Okay, we're good there. Did push it in. Did put the I know. Okay, well let's reset it to the correct parameters for startup again. So that should be in there in slot 1. Now the slots here correspond 1 through 6 to the programs listed down there. Let me come down here. I know where I made a mistake. There's a parameter I forgot to change in the program before I started it up. So if I edit holo, let me I'll kind of try and go through this a little bit real quick. So first I've wrapped a parental M to the bottom, which is the monitor, and C, which is the chest on the end of the network cable, container chest 0. So if you put the monitor on a different side, you would need to change that. If you put the container, if the container has a different number here, you would need to put it to that number, like. So then I set the text scale on the monitor to 0.5, so it makes the letters smaller, so I can fit more text on there if I would like to. I thought it looked better with a smaller scale. That's as small as it'll go, and it has to be in multiples of 0.5, so all the way up to 5, from 0.5 to 5. So, and then I made some functions. I made a function that makes a button and a bunch of math to calculate where it puts that text on the screen. A whole bunch of math. like I said, you can download the code and take a look at it yourself. And then I have the draw screen function, which actually draws all the buttons on the screen. Of course, right now it's a big red blob that actually draws all... Oops, didn't want to do that. So this function just draws all the buttons on the screen. So I can call this function anytime I want to reset the screen to have the buttons on it. And in the draw screen, it calls the button function, which is it. I pass it several variables. I pass it the L. I don't know what L. I don't remember what L was. Oh, the location of button 1 through 6. And then the name line 1 and the name line 2. So you see down here I've got Eden program, dungeon program, unset program, etc. And then color 1 and color 2. So this is going to be, the first color is the background color and the second color is the color of the text. So I can set all of those as I send these. So as I'm setting up programs, we'll just say new program, and we'll change this color to the background color to blue is the default. Up here you can see that it sets it automatically default of blue and automatically text color white. So what if we want to do, how about yellow? Yellow, and we'll make the background color something obnoxious. That's going to be super obnoxious. I might not even be able to read it, but there we go. We'll change that. So yeah, that just basically draws the screen. Back to down here. Okay, the load function basically is the whole load function is what it goes through whenever I click one of those buttons. Which it's sending down further. I'll show you where it actually decides what button. It's all that. It's like crazy amount of like all that, those loading, fancy loading thing. All this M writes and stuff like that, and get that make that loading thing in the middle of the screen. So spend a little bit of probably spend too much time on it. And then I go draw screen. This is basically the beginning. So I draw the screen, and then I do this. This is the loop right down here. The while true do. Local event. Basically, what this does is it says, if we look at the end of this line, basically I'm looking for an event, and it has to be a monitor touch event. And when there's a monitor touch event, it sets these 4 variables. I don't care about the first two. These are the ones I want, the X and the Y. And then I compare those X and Y to decide what program. See, prog equals 1 and all the way down to prog equals 6, depending on what the X and Y positions are, using some greater than, less than, basically to determine where on the monitor that I clicked. And then this, some debugging thing right there, that print. This print is also another debugging thing. That shows up in this console whenever the program is running. So, and that's the end of it. So basically then it does the load function and sends the variable prog, the program, 1 through 6. Go way back up here to where the very beginning of the load program was at. Load program. And basically what it does is it uses that, it pushes an item from the chest down, and it pushes it from the slot P. So either one, so slot 1 through 6. So P is what is being passed from below. And if it doesn't push anything, then it's going to equal 0, and that's going to cause an error, set text goes. I should actually have a set background color to black right here too, because that's why that screen's red down there, because I forgot to somewhere I forgot to turn the screen, the background color back to black after turning it back, turning it red. It's not a big deal. Not a big deal at all. If it's functioning right, you should never see that. So, where was the thing that I really needed to fix? Redstone. I should have set that as a variable. Redstone output, instead of having this right, it's actually on the left. So this is what caused my error. So my redstone set output left instead of right. And I've actually got to change that in four places because, like I said, I should have set this as a variable at the top. Maybe I will fix that. But right now it's working. Just gotta change it in these four different places and then it'll be fixed. But it'll be easier in the future if you could just change this in one spot at the top, depending on how you want to reconfigure it. Or depending on how you set up your pieces parts. So I happen to have the in my single player, I happen to have the redstone wire or the rednet cable connected to the right side. But on here, I have it connected to the left, which caused it not to work and then errored out. So there we go. Now hit Control, save, exit, and then just do a reboot to make it go. All right, let's see if I fixed it. And you can see that I got a new button. It says new program. And that's obnoxious, very obnoxious. So I set the background color yellow and the text color orange. Very obnoxious. All right, Eden program. And if everything goes right, it should switch to a button that says unload. Now, next time I click that, it'll unload. I don't want to do that till I come in. Oh, look here. We're in a little garden. I was really sad when I was building this. I tried to use forestry trees instead of the standard vanilla trees. And the wood, the trunk wood, went into the system, but it left the leaves behind. So forestry leaves would not go into the applied energistic storage cell. So, and then I just I surrounded the walls with blue to kind of simulate the distant sky thing. I guess doesn't do a very good job of simulating, but then, you know, little Eden-like area. You know, some flowers and a little, what do they call these things? I forget. Things. Well, there we go. Now, as long as nobody comes by and clicks the unload button while you're inside, you're going to be all good. But now you come out here, click unload, it'll go unloading. And wow, another error. What happened there? Oh, something happened. Something bad. All right, let me debug this again. What we got going on here? So it's still got this in here. It put the thing back inside it. Yeah. Did I miss one of the spots that's supposed to say redstone signal? And bottom, okay. Edit, hollow. No. Not whole. Okay, nothing like debugging a computer craft program in the middle of an episode. Maybe I should have tested this beforehand, but it worked really good in my single player. Alright, so somewhere down here, left, true, left, false. No, we're good there. Pull from down, slot 2, that's correct. Everything seems correct. Left. Down to left. Left. Down. Okay. Let me try something real quick. All right. Well, let me reset it. Reset it back to state, and we'll see if we can get it to work all the way through once. I think I might know, maybe know why it didn't do what it was supposed to. I don't think I gave it long enough for the cells to charge all the way back up. So that might be something I need to consider. Is either coming up with a way to check the charge level or increasing the cell storage so that it has the ability to both store and load and unload it all at once. You know, load it and then unload it again, like, immediately. So if I'm pretty sure this is all right. We'll just run holo. Okay, we're good. I bet if I clicked it right now, yeah, we're unloaded. I bet if I clicked it right now, it wouldn't go. Because, yeah, our cells aren't charged up yet. So if I look down here, I gotta wait till this gets to full power right here. There we go. We have enough power to make it work now. I'm gonna go down and load it. Oh, there we go. Eden program. Loading it up. Now, it actually loads almost immediately. There we go. So we're back to having an Eden program out. Okay, it loads almost immediately. And we'll come over here. Now, what I need to do is I need to wait until this absolutely has enough power. So, well, it's going to take a few minutes. Okay, so yeah, that's something I'm going to fix. Probably what I'll do is I'll add a couple of the dense storage cells. You know how I have this one dense storage cell up here? I'll probably convert these other three into dense storage cells, and that should be enough to keep it from having that little issue we just had. Because what I'm pretty sure that what happened is I tried to unload it before it had fully recharged its cell power. And I think that's why I did that. I also fixed the reactor. Reactor was powered down again when I logged on today. So it says, please leave the cell pattern in here when done. Because I put an ME interface and taught it how to craft fuel rods by sending this, a piece of iron. And just so long as we remember to put the cell extruder back in there whenever we're done using it for anything else, we should be good. So now the system can totally, completely keep itself refueled all the time. Probably something else I need to do, because I'm pretty sure that our loaders have run out of juice. Goes dumb down here. This one seems to have some power, or seems to have some ender pearls. I think Raccoon keeps that one full, but I think he often forgets to fill this one up. Because if this one's not full, we can't do any auto-crafting. Or the system can't auto-craft. And then it'll still run out of power, because it won't be able to think. It won't have access to these crafting monitor computer things. So, alright, let me come down here and I want to verify that I have enough power in the system to unload it. Looks like it. Looks like that cell's fully charged right there. So if I... Definitely, it's fully charged. When I come down here and I push the unload button and something bad happens, then I'm at a loss. There we go. Unloading. Aha! Ta-da! Okay, cool. We're good. So then it gives us this menu again. Alright. Now I won't be able to load another program until, again, those cells charge up. Actually, I can access that right here. So that might be something I need to look into, either just increasing all these energy cells so that this has a lot of power and I don't have to worry about the recharge time on them, because they'll have like the ability to charge up and stuff. So let's push one of these buttons that doesn't have a cell yet, and you see what happens. This is what it's supposed to do. Holo 42, an error has occurred. Please contact engineering. And what will happen is the program will crash out, and basically you have to get into the terminal to restart it. But that, and basically what happens is whenever it can't, like I said, whenever it doesn't have a cell or something goes wrong in the process, it'll just shut off and stop. That's also going to be useful so you don't get your cells mixed up. Anyway, there's the Eden one. I haven't made the dungeon one yet. Still waiting. See if anybody sends me some holodeck programs. I might try to make a few more myself. Until... There we go. Yeah, we're still... What I need to do is just reboot that up here. So, yeah, that's definitely a serious issue with the power supply. So... I will fix that in case anybody else goes using this. I want them to be able to load and unload a program in a relatively short period of time, because I can just imagine the first person that sees this comes up and goes, ooh, they're going to click that. They're going to go in. They're going to look around for like 2 seconds. I'm like, oh, this is neat. And they're going to come out and they're going to hit the unload button. And then it's going to error because the power is not charged up enough. So that's the only drawback of my system right here. Now, that's not a problem with the computer craft part. That's actually a problem with my power design on this. I just didn't use enough cells or enough big enough cells to support a few loads and unloads in rapid succession. So I think that's about it for that. I mean I can't really, I don't want to bore you anymore with trying to explain that program, and just download it and look at it. And if you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments. Like I said, I may change that one thing to be a variable at the top so that it'd be easier for people to change it later on. You just have to change it in one spot where the side that the redstone is connected to. Haven't done anything else new. We did get a bunch more osmium. We had the system managed to fill itself up entirely with bows and armor and stuff from our spawning things down here continuously running. So we shut them down. You can see that we took out the cursed earth. So this will no longer run continuously. And we won't get all those extra mobs spawning in there anymore. If you come over here and look. 53,000 buckets of mob essence. I think we're good. I think we're good for a while. And Raccoon was on earlier and we had enough to make, I think it was 3 more bedrockium blocks. Bedrockium blocks. Yeah, what we got? 3 bedrockium blocks and some bedrockium ingots. And so, yeah, we've got resources and resources and resources and unlimited power and stuff. So, I don't know, guys. You got to let me know what you want to see me do before the end of the series, because we're getting really close. I'm not sure what else to do. I still want to go to the Twilight Forest. That's going to be like an episode and defeat all the bosses. Raccoon did a similar episode, so I'm going to try to do it a little. I guess I'm not really, not like I can do it a whole lot differently. I don't think I've done anything over. Yeah, I don't think anything else has happened over here at the village since last time I was over here. Maybe some of the villagers bred? No? Lots of animals on the island. So yeah, still some building needs to be done over here. Lots more trees need to be grown. But I don't think it's anything different than the last time you guys seen it, so. So yeah, let me know how I can make another episode. Like I said, it'd be good if there's something you want me to review, if there's something that you'd like me to revisit, or if you can think of something that I haven't done that would be part of this mod pack, that would be awesome to do. I mean, I've touched on a little bit of everything. I've done a little bit of magic automation. I've done almost everything GregTech. I've done almost everything applied energistics wise. And yeah, I even did a little computer craft now. So bees and trees and all that stuff. Did all that. So yeah, I think I'm gonna call this episode done. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know it was a little bit boring with the computer code and stuff, but again, I hope somebody sends me something for these other three. I might be able to pull together three myself from somewhere. This one was kind of inspired from something. Well, the Eden one was kind of inspired from something I found online. Not exactly the same, though, as what I seen, but pretty close. Dungeon, I kind of know what I want to do for that. I have no idea what I'll do for that third one. I hope somebody will send me something for these other ones. Go ahead, send it to me on tweet it to me or post it in the comments. Or send me a message on YouTube. I should be able to get it. But again, hope you guys enjoyed this as much as I enjoyed making it. I had a lot of fun writing that program. It's been a long time since I've done computer craft, so I was a little rusty. And it's very not elegant as much as I would like it to be, but I might refine it further. And it's I have access to the pastebin, so if I refine it, you'll get access to a newer version of it if you use that pastebin code. So until next time, I will catch you later.